Well, good morning. And it is Friday, February 26th. Good to be with you. A little later than normal, about 10 o'clock. If you're watching the live stream, if you're watching a little bit later on, it's 10 o'clock in the morning as we do this, or just after 10. But good to be with you on this final weekday as we look forward to the weekend. Do want to encourage you along a couple of lines. Don't forget tomorrow. Is our men's prayer breakfast at 8 o'clock, and then services on Sunday, beginning with Sunday school at 9:45. So hope you can be there for that. Let's look at Psalm 69 here today. Psalm 69, and we'll make just a couple of comments today as we kind of dive into the middle of Psalm 69 here. All right, look with me at verse number 10. Psalm 69, verse number 10. When I wept and chastened my soul with fasting, that was to my reproach. I made sackcloth also my garment, and I became a proverb to them. They that sit in the gate speak against me, and I was in the song of drunkards. And so here we got David here, showing you kind of just kind of where he's at. He's saddened. It says, when I wept and chastened my soul with fasting, that was my reproach in verse over 10. We see that there are those that sit in the gate. They're talking about him, talking bad about him, or gossiping about him. Verse number 13, we kind of get a glimpse now as we look through the next couple of verses here. Really, David's prayer, we kind of see where David's at emotionally and mentally. Look at verse number 13. He says, though he's got all this going on, he says, verse 13, but as for me, my prayer is unto thee, O Lord. In an acceptable time, O God of the multitude of thy mercy, hear me in the truth of thy salvation. He says, deliver me out of the mire, let me not sink, let me be delivered from them that hate me and out of the deep waters. Let not the water flood overflow, neither let the deep swallow me up, and let not the pit shut her mouth upon me. And so, just a thought here, David here reaching out to the Lord, as we've seen many times throughout these Psalms, in prayer. And then he says, God, it's almost like David's a little discouraged, maybe even depressed a little bit. And he says, God, you've got to deliver me out of the mire. Let me not sink. And so we see where David's focus is. David knows all this is going on around him, the difficulty, those that are speaking bad about him. We see that he says, when he wept and chastened my soul, it looks like he's mourning here as well. And he says, God, don't let me sink. God, save me, rescue me if you will. Don't allow me to be overwhelmed by what's going on in my life. And in verse number 16, we see also, as David's going through the suffering, he says, verse 16, hear me, O Lord, for thy loving kindness is good. Turn unto me according to the multitude of thy tender mercies. Asking the Lord for his loving kindness, for his mercy, he says, and hide not thy face from thy servant, for I am in trouble. Hear me speedily. Draw nigh unto my soul and redeem it. Deliver me because of mine enemies. And so David here asking the Lord for deliverance from his enemies, for deliverance from the suffering that he is going through in his life. And just a thought, and I know we've kind of mentioned this quite often here, as we've looked at these Psalms, but the Lord is the one that can deliver. The Lord is the one that can walk us through the trials and difficulties of our life. We must simply trust Him and follow Him. There's going to be people in your life that they hurt you, they discourage you, they don't have your best interest at heart. And so let me tell you, the Lord is the only one that stays the same. He's the only one that is there yesterday, today, and forever. Mankind will hurt us. Mankind is not perfect. Mankind will fail us. Let's seek the Lord. Let's run to the Lord. Seek his loving kindness. Seek his mercy. It says, verse number 18, I like it. Draw nigh unto my soul and redeem it. Deliver me because of mine enemies. The Lord is the one that can deliver you from difficulty, deliver you from your trial. Seek the Lord. And let me tell you, it's kind of reminds me of, you remember when Peter walked out on the water towards Jesus? And Peter was walking great when his focus was right. You remember that? He was focused on Jesus. And then we know that when Peter took his eyes off the Lord, off of Jesus, that's when he began to sink. And David, maybe he was sinking a little bit as he looked at everything that was going on around him. Maybe he was sinking a little bit. And he kind of refocused back on God and he says, God, hey, don't allow me to be overwhelmed. Don't allow me to keep sinking. God, extend your hand of mercy, of loving kindness, your hand of mercy, your hand of loving kindness. Extend that to me. And God, draw nigh to me. David, God, I want you. I want you to be with me. God, I want to be close to you. I'm tired of sinking. I'm tired of being overwhelmed. God, I'm looking to you. And may that be our heart's desire, our heart's attitude, to look to the Lord, to lift us up even in our most difficult days. And so I want to leave you with that thought for the day and hope to see you in church this weekend. Good morning, Lucinda. Good morning, Cliff and Karen. Thanks for being on. Once again, I'm sorry we're a little bit later than normal, but thank you for being on this morning. And those of you who are watching later this afternoon, or maybe this evening, thank you so much for being a part of the Power Up time. Hey, I want to encourage you, men, be here for our prayer breakfast tomorrow at 8 o'clock if you can. And it'll be a great time of fellowship. And also have a challenge from the Word of God there as well. Well, God bless you. And we'll see you hopefully Sunday for services, maybe our prayer breakfast, but definitely Monday for our Power Up time. Have a great day. Have a great weekend. Thank you. Good morning, Susan. Thanks for being on this morning as well. And have a great rest of the day, everybody. And let's honor the Lord in all that we do.